Welcome to r/IDontWorkHereLady, where we share stories about folks that go into other businesses and have irate customers mistake them for employees. And today's story is My 32-Hour Workday. Not sure if this is the right thread, but after seeing some of these posts, I think it might be. This is my first post. I've watched a lot of the YouTube videos and have so many stories, but this is my go-to when I have to sum up the worst work experience I've had in my short career. And I was a telemarketer for a few months, so... Now, to lay this story out, I live within a 2-minute drive from my local mall. I've grown up going to this mall almost every day, know the layout by heart, and know a lot of the employees and other frequent shoppers. I had moved from New York to Virginia for my first year of college, but due to extreme medical issues, I had to move home and take a year off of school. So logically, I got 2 part-time jobs at this mall. I started working for a huge lingerie and bra store with a certain fashion show I'm sure you could figure out, while also working at a certain chain charm bracelet and other fine jewelry store. The 2 stores were about 40 feet apart entrance-wise, with just another single store in between, so most days I would take back-to-back shifts, rather than head home and come back. Now, at this bra store, I did everything. I processed shipment, I sold both in the mature and the young area, I repped beauty, I rang at cash wrap, I worked so many overnights it was ridiculous, because even as part-time, my weeks would often consist of 50 to 60 hours at this store. And I love my job, but when I was off the clock, I was off the clock. The issue is, my regulars wouldn't understand this. I feel like more customers would ask for my help when I was off the clock around the store than when I was on the clock. I would always help minimally or direct to one of my associates who was actually working. No big deal. Now, on Thanksgiving and Black Friday, I was hustling. I had a shift at the jewelry store from 4 to 8 p.m., followed by a shift at the bra store from 8:15 p.m. to 6 a.m., followed by a shift at the jewelry store from 6:30 a.m. to 1 p.m., and then back for my final shift at the bra store from 1:30 p.m. to 12 a.m. I knew during my 1 half-hour break I would have to walk a few more storefronts down to another popular chain girls' clothing store to pick up 3 things they let me put on hold for my little sister. But I would have to walk in, get my stuff from under their counter, get on the line, check out, and run to my job. Now, I'm paraphrasing all this, but mainly just editing out mass profanity. I clock out at 1 p.m. on the dot, and I book it to the store, and immediately beeline for the counter. Enter Entitled Customer Mom 1. Entitled Customer Mom 1. Danny, is that you? Now, my name isn't Danny, but it's in the realm of sounding similar, so I ignore it. There is approximately 40 customers in here everywhere, not expecting one to be looking for me. I stop at a display for a second by a pile of t-shirts, seeing if I could possibly grab another cheap black shirt because, to be honest, at this point, I had thoroughly sweat through mine in the past 22-ish hours I had already worked. Entitled Customer Mom 1. Danny, don't ignore me. Now closer. I look around and don't really see anyone go back to the pile of shirts, until I am grabbed by the back of my shirt's collar. Entitled Customer Mom 1. Danny, what the heck? I've been calling you. I turn around to see one of my regulars at the bra store. She's a mom of 3, and since I started there, she comes in every 2 weeks for a fitting from me, because she was diagnosed with diabetes and is trying to lose a lot of weight. She has lost a lot, but she's still rather large, and I'm surprised I didn't notice her earlier. Me. Oh, hey, Stacy. How are you? Any good deals today? Entitled Customer Mom 1. I'm trying to shop, but they won't open a fitting room for me. Me. Oh, that's rough. I've already worked both jobs already today and it's been a madhouse, and I actually got a run to be at bra store in 15 minutes. I'm just grabbing some stuff for B, my sister. I begin to walk away, but still giving her all the attention I can. Entitled Customer Mom 1. BS. Me. Excuse me? She's following me now. I keep going to retrieve what they had on hold for me. Entitled Customer Mom 1. I saw you grab that t-shirt in your hand in a medium. Your sister's not a medium, you are. BS, you're shopping for your sister. Open a fitting room for me. I'm now at the counter and my coworker's girlfriend sees me and is grabbing the bag I had for my sister. Me. I don't work here. I can't open a fitting room. Stacy, I'm sorry. Receives bag and checks inside. And you're right, the shirt's for me. I've been working since yesterday. I needed a change of shirt, but this whole bag is for B. Entitled Customer Mom 1. Are you kidding me? Me. No. Now walking to get on the unexpectedly short line for checkout. Entitled Customer Mom 1. You can't have holds on Black Friday. You work at X store and X store. You can definitely open that fitting room for me. Me. I can't hear, but in 10 minutes I can open one for you in X store when I clock in. Entitled Customer Mom 1. You're using your R sister as an excuse not to help me. Okay, more context is, my sister's autistic, and so is one of Stacy's kids, and bra fittings get personal, and I see her every 2 weeks. I know her as well as she knows me, but never before has she ever been like this. Enter Entitled Customer 2, unknown identity to me. Entitled Customer 2. Are you kidding me? You're refusing to help her? Me. I'm not refusing to help her. I don't work here and I cannot help her. Entitled Customer Mom 1. You must work here. They have a bra fit specialist position in this store. That's your job. Entitled Customer 2. I saw you go to the counter. That woman over there knew you and gave you a hold. No one can have holds on Black Friday. You must work here. Me. That woman is my friend. That woman is my coworker's girlfriend, and that woman owns this franchise and allowed me to put things on hold so my sister doesn't have to be in this environment. Finally, it's my turn, and my friend F is the open register. I go up, followed by Entitled Customer Mom 1 and Entitled Customer 2. And this is where I learn my fatal error. Me. Hey, I have to be at work in 5. I'm sorry if I'm causing a scene. Friend. It's okay. I hope B likes these. Entitled Customer Mom 1. You're a lesbian. Entitled Customer Mom 1 is now angry, almost pushing me aside at the counter, yelling at the cashier, my friend. Friend. Yes? Is there an issue? I can be with you in 1 second, ma'am. Entitled Customer Mom 1 to me. That means the other lesbian works at the bra store. She works around naked women. Me. Most of our customers don't shop naked, but yes, I guess she does do that. Entitled Customer Mom 1. That means she has gotten off to touching me. That perverted a-hole. Entitled Customer 2. Oh my god, they allow gays to work at X store? I'm calling. I'm going there. Oh my god. Me. Taking my receipt. Thank you again. Friend. You're welcome. Now I have to run to work, but I turn to Entitled Customer Mom 1 and Entitled Customer 2. Me. Yes, a lesbian works at X store. There are multiple. There are also multiple gay guys and multiple transgender and non-binary associates at our store. And in our staff. And I can assure you the last thing they would get off to is a customer shopping in our store. I walk away and kind of jog the 120 feet to my store and into the back to clock in. I would hope it ended there, but immediately I turn on my headset to hear my manager calling me into room 3. We have 9 rooms on the floor, not including the fitting rooms. Number 3 is front and center. I head that way, figuring they may have moved where I was stationed. Entitled Customer Mom 1 and Entitled Customer 2 stand in all their fuming glory, ranting to my manager how I refused to service both of them. My manager, M, is 30 and does comedy with me. We take very little seriously, and especially customers like this. Manager. Danny, have you been in store? They're saying you're refusing to help them. Where are you stationed? Me. Yeah, I just clocked in. When I refused to help them, it was while I was checking out an X store buying stuff for B 5 minutes ago. Manager. Twitching, trying not to snicker. You're telling me she wasn't helping you two while she was at a store she didn't work at? Entitled Customer Mom 1. No, she wouldn't open fitting rooms here 12 minutes ago. She shouldn't be in charge of something she refuses to do. Entitled Customer 2. I can testify. I witnessed her refusing to open the fitting rooms. Me. Hey manager, I'm sorry. I do have my phone hidden, but here. I pull out my phone, show the receipt, and show my clock in screen that shows I clocked in 3 minutes and 47 seconds earlier, and I had checked out of the other store 4 minutes before that. Manager. She couldn't help you because she doesn't work there. Entitled Customer 2. She refused to help us, though. My manager looks exhausted and begins to reach in her beauty tool belt for a customer complaint coupon, and I wasn't going to let them get that extra 30% off. Me. Well, you know what? Hi, welcome to X Store. My name is Danny. When was the last time you've been measured? Entitled Customer Mom 1. No, I don't want your help anymore. I want you to face the consequences of your actions. Me. Well, I'm sorry, ma'am, but if you don't want my help, I'll just let you know the deals for today. List off the sales. Happy shopping. Now, do you need any help? Entitled Customer 2. No, this is BS. Wipe that grin off your face. Me. I'm so sorry I can't help you two. If you have any questions to ask, now. If you need anything, my name is Danny. Don't hesitate to ask. I grab my manager and turn around to head to another part of the store, and the two women follow us, and I'm 90% sure one starts filming me walking with my manager. So we keep talking pleasantries and head into the private back of our store. We go into the office and I tell her everything I've written here, and we kind of camp out watching the cameras as these two women stand holding their phones at the door we went into to enter the back. My manager thinks it's hilarious and we keep watching them on the camera. They evolve to peak Entitled Customer. Entitled Customer Mom 1 walks up to the shipment manager, SM, who is cleaning and organizing the merchandise by the door. We could see everything but hear nothing on the cameras. Entitled Customer 2. One of your associates stalked us and followed us here. She's not on the clock and she's trying to steal from us, and probably you need to call mall security immediately. My poor shipment manager is rarely on the floor. It's her first Black Friday in the store, and she's standing there wide-eyed, not sure what to do. Now, she's also hard of hearing, so she thinks they may have attempted to speak to her before they began yelling, but she didn't hear them clearly enough to know for sure. We saw them targeting her and decided it was time to call mall security on them. entitled Customer Mom 1. You're an idiot. This whole store employees, much profanity, idiots. Entitled Customer 2. You should all be ashamed. You're all slander. Shipment Manager. Excuse me, I'm hard of hearing. Can you speak louder? Entitled Customer 2. You're a straight up R, huh? Maybe this will help. Now I swear to the Lord, this woman slaps my shipment manager in the hearing aid, the area directly behind her left ear. I scream and one of my trans associates, male to female, who has always been a bodybuilder and teaches self-defense classes, runs from the back and tackles Entitled Customer 2 to the floor. She is pinned and screaming. My coworker will not let up. Entitled Customer 2. I'm being molested. I'm being harassed. They're hurting me. This man is on me. Etc. 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 My shipment manager runs in the back crying, and I go to comfort her and check on her hearing aid. Entitled Customer 1 goes to run, but before doing so, she yells for the whole store to do this. Entitled Customer Mom 1. I am taking these because of the way Danny Walker treated me, and there is no reason I do not deserve them. She proceeds to grab 4 perfumes and some random panties off a table and sprint out of the store. Soon after that, we decided to close early on Black Friday, as we had to file mall complaints, security reports, police reports, medical reports, and theft reports, all because I wouldn't let a woman into a fitting room at a store I didn't work at. For months, my coworkers didn't tell me what she yelled before she left, because I take things like that personally, even though I know I have no control over it. But Stacy hasn't returned to my store or any store owned by my company since that incident, as there is now a lifetime ban and cameras that check every face in every store looking for one to match hers. I hope you enjoyed this story. Thanks for listening. If you have your own story, please send them to me in the comments below. Don't forget to subscribe, and we'll see you next time.